Second.
Yeah. You realize that this problem is exactly half of the previous one. Though initially it looks double of the previous, it's actually half of the previous. Approach is same. Right cortex, under root cortex has 1 by under root tan x. Multiply divided with 6 squared.
Yeah.
Take root tan x as t, or tan x is t squared. Once you get this, multiply divide by 6 squared. Then take tan of x as t square. You will get 1 plus t square dt. I'm sorry. 6 square x dx will be 2t dt. So it will become 2t by t into 1 plus t to the power 4. Are you getting this? So t and t will get cancelled. 2 you can take outside. Divide by t square. Take t minus 1 by t as k, which means 1 plus 1 by t square dt is equal to dk. So it's 2 dk by k square plus 2. So the answer will be 2 times 1 by root 2 tan inverse k by root 2, correct? Because I can write this 2 as root 2 square. So answer is root 2 tan inverse. K itself is t minus 1 by t, and t itself is root tan x. So root tan x minus 1 by root tan x by root 2. You can present an answer in this form also. Tan inverse tan x minus 1 by root of 2 tan x plus 7. Next question is, integrate 1 by cos to the power 6x plus sin to the power 6x. That I don't know. If I am doing it under this heading, probably the same form. Should I erase this, this one or not? Again, a very well-known question. You'll be surprised, yesterday a class 11 student asked me this.
Who, Bharat Shankar?
Bharat. He's solving.
He started solving integration for me.
Since childhood is doing.
What?
Integration.
Oh, Gaurav.
Gaurav.
Gaurav Shastri.
Yesterday I asked them a question on sets. If there is a set having n elements, how many pair of disjoint sets you can make from it? If there is a set having n elements, how many pairs of disjoint sets can you make from that set? And they solved it also. Supposedly a JEE main question. Which term?
Cos
square
plus
sin square. So write it as cos square plus sin square whole square minus some. After that you realize it becomes pretty easy.
No, no, no. Divide the cost of cost for that. Then you take tan root square.
Okay, so first of all, I broke cos to the power 6 plus sin to the power 6 is cos square cube plus sin square cube. So that I can easily apply the formula of a cube plus b cube written in the factor form. So I get dx by, this is your a, this is your b, a cube plus b cube. So it becomes a plus b. The answer? Tan a 2.
Let's discuss this.
So I'll get cos to the power 4. Sin to the power 4. Minus sin square x cos square x. Correct? Which is 1. This term I can write it as cos square x plus sin square x whole square minus 2 sin square x cos square, and this will become minus 3 sin square cos square. So far so good?
Yeah.
Which is nothing but dx by 1 minus 3 sin square x cos square x. Now multiply numerator and denominator with c to the power 4x. Can I say in the denominator I would get this term? Yes sir? Write c to the power 4 as sec square into sec square, and write one of the sec squares as 1 plus tan square. Okay. In the denominator as well, you can do the same thing. You can write this as sec square square, which is 1 plus tan square square. Correct? The benefit of doing this is when you substitute tan x as t, then secant square x dx will be observed as dt, and you would get 1 plus t square by 1 plus t to the power 2 whole square minus 3 t square. Correct me if I'm wrong, it will be 1 plus t square dt by t to the power 4 minus t square plus 1, correct? Now is the form familiar to you?
Yeah.
What do you do next? Nishal?
Divide by
t square. Correct. So you'll get 1 plus 1 by t square and you'll get t square plus 1 by t square minus 1. Then what do you take as k?
1 minus t
minus
1 by t.
T minus 1 by t. So basically 1 plus 1 by t square dt will become dk. So the entire integral will convert to dk by t square plus 1, right? This is simply tan inverse t. Correct?
Yeah.
And t is what? Sorry, it will be k square. So tan was k, and k will be t minus 1 by t, and t will be tan x. Is that okay?
Sir.
Yeah. The book they say it's tan inverse tan x minus cot x. Yes, 1 by tan x can be written as cot x. Huh? question is, there is a set which has got n elements. Okay. There is set A which has got n elements. A1, A2, A3, till A. How many pairs? Pairs means two. How many pairs of disjoint sets can you make from A? So how many ways can you split this as two sets? X and Y, where X and Y are subsets of A, and they are.
What is this, sir?
Mutually exclusive.
What is
joint? Disjoint.
Meaning.
Meaning. What is that? In how many ways can you find sets X and Y such that X and Y are subsets of A and they are disjoint? I was teaching sets yesterday, so I okay, without wasting much time, anybody have any idea how to do it? No idea. Do it fast, we have a lot of integrations to cover. Okay. If you want to form a subset from A, every element of A will have three choices. Either to go to X, or to go to Y, or to stay back in A. Correct? Right? So like that we have n elements, so can I say 3 to the power n would be the number of ways you can make subsets where they are disjoint, except for one such case when both of them become null sets, when every element chooses to stay in A. Correct? So you do one thing, you subtract that case. I'm not saying that case is not going to be in your answer, because null intersection null is also null.
Yeah.
Okay. But I want pairs, so I have to divide it by 2, because whether you write xy or yx means the same thing. Correct? But you cannot form a pair when both the elements are the same things.
And then?
Right? It's like, how many ways can you write 36 as a pair of two factors? You will say 1 into 36, 2 into 18, 3 into 12, 4 into 9, then
6 into 6,
then it starts going backwards, right? 9 into 4, 12 into 3, 18 into 2, 36 into 1. So if I ask you how many ways you can break it into pairs, you will count them all excluding this and divide by 2 and then add 1. Similar thing what I am going to do is subtract 1, divide by 2 and add
1.
So your answer is 3n, 3 to the power n plus 1 by 2. And they got this. You can have a subsets which are both null set and null set. Okay? But you cannot say this null set and this null set when change position will give you two cases. So I subtracted that one case and divided by 2. And then added that one.
Why
did
you add
that
one?
Because null intersection null will also give you a null. See, why did I subtract this case from, if I want to know how many ways can I divide it into two factors? My answer will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Because originally there are these 5 ways only, right? This is just a repetition of this, this is just a repetition of this, this is just a repetition of this. In the same way, 3 to the power n is this, subtract the 1. That one is when both are null null.
Okay.
So if you subtract, that means both will be different. Correct? So this and this are considered the same. That's why I divided it by 2. And then I added that 1. Is that okay?